Off to Weatherfield, where Sharon Marshall's behind the scenes of Corrie's latest drama-filled nuptials. But will it be fifth time lucky for weak-willed Peter Barlow?
Or will poor Carla be left alone at the altar?
Or will he ride off into the sunset with Tina?
Or will someone write down on a piece of paper somewhere that that was supposed to happen?
Let's find out.
Once again, Corrie's dearly beloved are gathered here today to witness the marriage of Peter Barlow and his beautiful bride. So, I hear you ask yourselves, haven't we been here before? Oh yes, four times before. Ah, but this time alcoholic bigamist Peter is due to marry unlucky and loved businesswoman Carla Connor.
Don't do it!
Don't you do it!
Don't you do it!
Stop the wedding!
Don't you do it!
So why am I so sceptical? Well, Peter's love life has been full of dramas, with more ups and downs than a pair of underwear knickers.
If somebody gets pleasure out of my knickers, then I'm happy.
So, Mr. Barlow, what's your excuse?
His problem really is that he gets to that point where he talks about being happy, he gets to that point and he can't let himself be happy. I don't know why. That's the one question that I can't answer, really.
Because you're a weak and feckless man, that's why.
Oh, that's why?
Because you're in Coronation Street and they all are.
Oh, yeah, that's it. Sorry, I forgot for a moment, yeah.
Peter's wedding woes began in 1990 when he married first wife Jessica Midgley, and he looked a bit different back then. That's more like it. And then with a new look came a new wife when in 2003 he wed Lucy Richards. But not content with being married to one woman, he decided to opt for bigamy. How big of him. When he married Shelley Unwin at the same time. But that didn't last. And in 2010, Leanne Battersby became Mrs. Barlow number four. But as Peter fell off the wagon...
I'm not drunk.
Yes, you are. Just get a piece.
I'm not Lee.
Leanne fell into Nick Tilsley's arms and divorce soon followed. So will it be fifth time lucky with Carla?
When it comes to ex-bookie Peter, the course of true love never did run smoothly. So what's stopping this marriage from going the distance? Well, might have something to do with a certain young filly.
Barmaid Tina McIntyre and Peter became friends after Tina helped look after his son Simon. But more recently, their friendship has entered new and dangerous territory, forcing Peter to question his impending marriage to Carla.
I'd be a fool to get mixed up with you.
Yes, you would.
The only problem is, I am a fool.
I can just feel the sexual tension. She has been getting very close to the groom.
Yes, she has. Although he's been sort of flirting with her, thinking a little bit he led her on, and because Tina's quite young and naive, she's gone along with it, and eventually I think she sort of started having feelings for him.
Yeah, but eventually having feelings for him on his wedding day.
I know! She shouldn't be here!
But moral dilemmas aside, let's move on to the most important topic, the dress.
I mean, doesn't the bride look lovely?
She looks absolutely gorgeous. I want to try the dress on.
Oh, you can't! You only have the groom, you can't have a dress as well.
No lace, got it. And sleeveless, I like that.
The dress, of course, is the handiwork of Carla's close friend and top seamstress, Hayley Cropper.
Hayley has done you proud.
Hasn't she done me proud? Hayley made all of this.
Gorgeous. Look at that.
I feel very, very like a girl and unlike me at all.
Do you know
it's
what? Underworld should go into wedding dresses and out from knickers. This is great.
I know. She's done well. The girl did good.
She looks beautiful. I've just got issues with the groom.
Oh, what do you mean? I have no idea what you mean. I'm just so happy to have finally got him down the aisle.
It has been a long story, hasn't it? I mean, she's loved him 4 years and he's been usually looking at other women or marrying other women like me.
Usually, yeah. But I think with her, you know, it has been different and so far, so good. But, you know, he's everything to her and he's completely the love of her life. And she's got to this big day and she just almost wonders whether he's going to turn up. So she's so relieved that he's there and it's an all-round good day so far.
So far, famous last words.
Does he love Carla, do you think?
Yeah, oh yeah, he loves her. He adores her, he's madly in love with her. That's not the problem.
Well, the problem is he's slept with most of the congregation. That's the problem we're going through.
Oh yeah. That might be the problem. Yeah, you can't look up with that going on.
Oh, it doesn't look good for Carla, does it? And it seems the soap gods are trying to tell her something. The set is falling apart. Surely that's divine intervention. And as they continue, there is yet another delay to proceedings. But this time, it's Roy Cropper sleeping on the job. Will these two ever tie the knot?
Are you all right, Dave? Or do you need 40 winks?
A cup of tea, please.
Well, poor Roy has had a rough time of it lately.
Roy, will you stop it? You're more upset than I am. It's a shame, but I'll live. Well, for a bit.
Sadly, the nation will soon be saying goodbye to the lovely Hayley Cropper as her battle with terminal cancer comes to an end. It's a touching storyline that has cemented Roy and Hayley's marriage as Corrie's strongest.
So, from the one marriage that's actually worked, yes, in the street,
yes,
what advice would you give our, well, we hope the happy couple today?
Well, I'd probably say don't do it, to be honest with you, because it's Peter, you know, he doesn't have a good track record. But I hope they'll be happy. Maybe she can change him. Maybe this is just a little spanner in the works, you know, Weatherfield style, and then they can be happy together. I hope so. I want happiness for Carla.
You rang up that beautiful dress.
I know, just in a matter of days, even though she's gravely ill as well. It's amazing, isn't it? I've learnt a lot of skills. I'm ready to face the world after Corrie now. I can foxtrot, I can use a Singer sewing machine, yeah. Like, you know, a little bit of conversational Spanish I learnt the other year, a bit of first aid.
And Hayley's not the only one leaving the cobbles behind, as we're promised a dramatic end for Tina when actress Michelle Keegan leaves the soap next year. But in reality, Michelle's love life couldn't be more different to her doomed characters, having got engaged to Essex boy Mark Wright earlier this year.
Any clues on what you might be doing? You're going to be here, away?
Well, to be fair, we haven't actually discussed it yet, I think, because I've been so busy and he's been away working for his new show, so we haven't actually had time to discuss things, so hopefully we'll be able to do, and we'll come up with a few ideas.
And hopefully it will go a little more smoothly.
It better had to.
Then stay.
I'm sure it will, and if today is anything to go by, I'd say Carla could do with all the looks she can get.
So we thought you need some little horseshoes.
Oh, good luck, horseshoes.
That's because that's for her and what she's like with men, and then because he's an alcoholic bigamist, and because
thank you.
There's a harlot on the back row,
thank
there's something you,
you
need I'm to wilting. Know about, and you know, I'm sorry, I just... Please,
oh,
all
no.
Look in the world, I
I'm
think
doomed.
She's going to... Good luck!
Too many horseshoes.
So, will my good luck charms be enough? Will Peter actually go through with the wedding? Will the soap gods have their way? Or will someone else put a stop to it? So many questions. Tune in to find out the answers tonight.